What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Jared, special guest Seth from The SoCo Show.
It's me.
Yeah, look at him. He's there. We're talking about Mandalorian Episode 5. We just got done watching it. Obviously, we're going to get into spoiler-free and then the spoilers of the episode and kind of what we thought overall. But before we do that, let us know what you guys thought of this Episode 5, if it's one of your favorites, one of your least favorites, in the comments down below. Let us know all of the great stuff about Mandalorian, I guess.
Yeah.
I don't know. Anyway, spoiler free, Seth, what did you think of this episode?
I think it was a little filler. I enjoyed parts of it. I like the casting a lot. They had Amy Sedaris and Ming-Na Wen. Amy Sedaris from one of my favorite shows, BoJack Horseman, and Ming-Na Wen from Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., which I'm a fan of.
Yeah.
Overall, just felt like kind of the last two, a little bit of filler, a little bit of like, what are they doing here? I was entertained, but I wasn't like, I gotta know what's going on next, because it didn't feel like there's a lot going on.
Yeah, yeah, definitely when we get into the spoilers, there's a little bit more there. But I'm glad that I watched this with you, because I didn't know about that casting, so that was kind of cool that those two were in there.
Yeah.
But I mean, it has the flavor of Mandalorian that we've had from, you know, the other episodes, but again, I feel like there wasn't much accomplished in this episode.
Yeah.
I'll just leave it there so we can get right into the spoilers. Ooh, because...
Right into it.
Right into it. It opens up with this... He's getting chased down by another bounty hunter.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought the first time I watched it, the second time it worked a little bit more for me. But the first time I watched it... He's literally saying what the Mandalorian is saying, like, I can take you out warm, or I can take you in cold. And I'm like, are we doing this right now? Do all the bounty hunters only have one line?
Yeah.
So that was kind of cool. I mean, the space where he jams on the brakes, that was cool. Mm-hmm. But otherwise, I thought it was very cheesy.
Yeah, a lot of cheesy moments in the episode. A lot of weird lines where you just kind of go... Like, what?
Well, even the opening, like I just mentioned, he jams, the guy flies by him, spaceship explodes, and then his spaceship goes through the explosion. It's like, da-da-da, Mandalorian!
Yeah. Yeah, it to me, like, I've been okay with up to this point, because I feel like we were maybe going somewhere.
Yeah.
And then we get to this episode, and like you said, a lot of the same stuff, a lot of the same lines, a lot of similar patterns that we've... Just every episode has kind of felt carbon copy ever since, like, episode 3 or chapter 3.
Yeah, I would say chapter 3 was, like, the apex of what we've seen so far.
Yeah, and ever since then, it just felt like it's kind of... And we get a little snippet at the end. We don't know who it is yet, but I'm thinking it's I almost said Giancarlo Stanton, the baseball player. Esposito.
Gus Fring. Gus Fring. Yeah, the thing. Going to the very end of the episode, that's probably... It's almost like a post-credits, mid-credits scene. And that was probably almost the highlight of the episode of seeing this and down of a character. We don't know who it is. It's probably, like you had mentioned, I'm glad, again, I watched this with you, because I had no clue who it was going to be.
It's funny because, like, you're way more into the Star Wars stuff.
Oh, and you're way more into characters.
Yeah, I like actors and all that stuff. So I'm like naming off like Amy Sedaris and Ming-Na Wen, and you're like,
this is what it was doing. It was just going over my head. I'm like, yeah, those are people I know.
Yeah.
So yeah, the very end right there, that's probably the highlight. But I mean, getting into the characters of it, the spaceport attendant, I thought that was very cheesy again.
Yeah.
It was... The dialogue, I guess, didn't land with me, and it's kind of like taking care of the child. And
I will say I liked her more as the episode went on. At first I thought it was a little off.
Yeah.
But as the episode went on, I did like her a lot more. And mostly because I'm a fan of hers. But I thought, like, her cadence and her style of delivery fit her character more as it went on.
Mm-hmm.
And you kind of get more endeared to her because of what she does with Baby Yoda and all that. Or... Can't say Baby Yoda.
Oh, spoiler. Well, now this is just copyrighted by Disney or whatever. But yeah, that's the thing is, it was almost... I think as the episodes are continuing, I'm realizing this is a kid's show.
Kinda.
Episodes 1 through 3, you watch that as a movie, that's borderline PG-13.
Yeah.
Episode 4, Episode 5 are very much taking the tone and more into the kid realm of Disney Plus, I feel like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree with that. Although I think there was, like, with putting the Stormtrooper helmets on the sticks.
Yeah.
And there's a little blood, it looked like, almost on the Stormtrooper helmet. So that maybe makes me think, like, there's still a little bit of adult stuff
in
here.
Yeah, a little bit of it.
But, yeah, I mean, it has taken that almost, like, even keel casual, like, you, I mean, there's a few hint, like, they talk about Tatooine, so there's like, oh, a little
bit.
Yeah,
I was going to say, did you kind of like how they're going back to stuff that we're familiar with, or do you kind of want them to expand out a bit more?
I do like that they're throwing in those bits and pieces, and, like, yeah. You can, you know, we can, we don't know if that bar is for sure where.
Exactly. So. We don't know if it's the exact same one. I mean, it's kind of similar because we see that other bounty hunter sitting essentially where Han Solo would be sitting. Definitely not what Han Solo is. This bounty hunter. You looked it up. You found out it was who?
Bobby Cannavale, he's in a ton of stuff. He was in Irishman recently.
Yes. Yep. And Mr. I really Robot. Enjoy it. Yeah, I really enjoy him as a character, but it was his son.
His son, yeah. He was weird to me. Like his he seemed like a we talk about kid show, like a big time Rush Nickelodeon character.
But then it's like, hey man, you're too old to be in these. Would you like to be in this show?
Yeah.
And I guess all of his dialogue, I felt like it was almost like this weird fish out of water, but just completely clueless to the whole. It was like someone that was taken out of our world and put into Star Wars and be like, what are we doing? You got shot? Your steel can block bullets?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, totally. I totally agree with that. He was the campiest. With an episode of the Amy Sedaris in it, who's very campy, he was the campiest thing in it. I also say, too, like, he died. So he got shot, or I guess we don't know if officially if he's dead.
Well, it seemed more like likely, he is.
And then Ming-Na Wen, they just killed her. And if you've seen this episode, she is really great at fighting. Like, she has a lot, like, that scene with Jake Cannavale where she's whooping him. She's great.
But that's only, like, 20 seconds, again, you don't want a huge, drawn-out, you know, John Wick-style fight scene. But I thought it was, again, you had even mentioned in the episode, that's kind of a waste. But I'm curious if that is Gus at the end somehow. Maybe they like put technology into her, bring her back. It's Star Wars. But I think that it's a one and done.
Yeah, and on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., I think she does all her own stunts. She's been in a bunch of stuff where she does a lot of fighting. So, it's disappointing to me that she's gone because she could have, and she's got really great charisma like on screen and stuff. Disappointed me that she was off like that. So, and in the way that it happened of him just being like,
you know, great, now I can get a bigger money, get bigger bounty.
It seemed like they make these characters a little stupid or a lot stupid in these cases. So, I mean, I still like the show. Like, it's entertaining. Like, I was entertained by it, but I just feel like the high they were riding to being like, where is this going? Now I'm just like, okay, what are they doing? Like, not where, like, where's this going? It's like, what are they doing?
Yeah.
You know, like, that's kind of where it switched.
And that's the thing is, like, you would even mention that you think that character at the end is the Gus character, Imperial. They have three episodes. I think that it's going to hopefully ramp up because I feel like these two in the middle, they didn't know what to do because they're going to and they have to bring back Gina Carano's character.
Yeah.
Kara, I don't know what the last name
Delevingne.
Was. Delevingne. Yeah, Kara Delevingne. But I think in the footage that they showed at Star Wars Celebration or a trailer, they show her just wrecking shop with like this big, essentially like the laser turret. So I think that she'll be back. Carl Weathers' character's got to come back.
Yeah.
Overall, in this episode, what was like your highlight, kind of like the best part of this episode? Again, we kind of both agree, I would say, a filler episode.
Another. I was okay with it up till now, like with some of the filler, but this one, it just felt like I needed something. I was sitting there waiting for something to happen, and I didn't. I'd say if they continue with Amy Sedaris, I wouldn't mind her continuing the show. I liked her a lot. I know it was campy at first, and most people probably won't agree with me, but I like her a lot. So if they continue with her and like maybe have her help in some way, I don't know. But otherwise, like maybe a little bit of the fighting. Some of the Baby Yoda moments,
which they toned down a little bit on him. He's kind of put away and not featured as much.
But otherwise, there wasn't a ton that I loved. I thought it was mostly just okay to boring almost in a way.
I think I'm on the other side of you with that. What's her name? The spaceship person.
I don't know her characters now. I just know it's Amy Sedaris.
Okay, Amy Sedaris.
I'm gonna call her Space Amy Sedaris.
The second time watching through, I felt a little bit more. I accepted it a bit more. Mm-hmm. The first time I watched, very cheesy.
Yeah.
I think the highlight of mine was the speeder scenes.
Those are cool.
But again, you had mentioned they looked a little weird, which I don't think it was entirely the speeder scenes, but it was the speeder scenes combined with the music.
Yeah.
Because the music, for some reason, when I wrote down notes the first time, I was like, it's Uncharted, it's tropical. Yeah. It had the Mandalorian vibe, but turned it a little bit. And I was like, I'm on board. It's like an adventure. I'm on board for this.
Yeah, it actually, I thought the music fit Tatooine pretty well. Yeah. Just like the environment of Tatooine, you know, very deserty and stuff. I thought that fit where I really like the music. Mm-hmm. I know the composer did Creed 2. Huge fan of Creed 2.
Yeah.
So I've enjoyed it, and I know people had issues with it at first. I've enjoyed it all the way through.
I think I have too as well. I know that, again, I think we know who was having problems with it. It didn't fit, but this is in the Star Wars world, but also it's not. It's something new.
Yeah. It does feel like a Western or samurai movie. There's been that
samurai
debate. God, we're just getting in all kinds of controversy.
Yeah, yeah.
But no, I still like the overall style of the show. It's for a Star Wars show, and I'm not a huge fan. Like you're way more into it. I'm a casual fan, mm-hmm. probably at best. I've enjoyed getting the Star Wars out of it that I've gotten, but it hasn't sucked me in to the, like, I guess the overall. I haven't been like super into the story because it just felt like not a lot's happened. So someone who watches a ton of TV.
Oh yeah.
I've enjoyed this and I've looked forward to it every week, but it's not a show where as soon as it drops, I'm like, gotta watch this. Mm-hmm. You know, for me, this is just entertaining. And a lot of people have issues with the length. I love that it's 30 minutes. Mm-hmm. I love a short episode. Keep it tight. Keep it packed.
Keep it tight. Well, I'm glad. I'm actually really glad to get your perspective because, again, I watch little to no TV. You watch a lot of TV, so when you woke up this morning, I'm like, it's only 30 minutes. You're like, yes, let's do this. We got a 30 minute episode.
I watch a lot of 30 minute episode TV, so I enjoy the shorter stuff, but you know, it is what it is. People have issues with it, but to me, I don't know what, like, maybe if they had more time they would go into more stuff.
Yeah,
but
then again, it could be a thing where, hey, you're given 45 minutes of fluff rather than 30 minutes.
Yeah, true.
So it could be a thing that benefits, but also could be a thing that really hurts it.
Yeah.
Anyways, though, that's our thoughts. Spoiler-free. Spoiler, obviously. It cut off there. Hopefully, I'll do something funny there. But let us know what you guys thought of episode 5. If you think that this is going to ramp up in 6, 7, 8.
Yeah.
Because there's a season 2 on its way.
Yeah,
so
I think filming now.
Yeah, maybe the Mandalorian dies and they bring the other guy back.
Yeah, well, you mentioned too, Gina Carano has to come back, you know, this season at some point. Carl Weathers, they've both been on set for season 2, so they're going to be back for sure. Oh, sorry.
Spoilers, people, wow.
Oh, crap. I'm excluded from reviews now.
No. Because we just got a little flavor of Gino Carano's character, so I want to see more of that. But anyways, what did you guys think? Let us know in the comments down below. I'm curious, you know, again, if this one, I went on Twitter, it's going to cause controversy.
Uh-oh.
So we're not going to.
Have you already gotten replies?
No, I haven't tweeted anything yet. I'm just going to stay away from that.
Oh, no.
But yeah, that's our breakdown of episode 5. Seth, do you have any plugs? Do you kind of want to just mention what we're doing, why we're doing filming this together?
Yeah, I mean, we're going to LA this weekend, so you're going on a little vacation, maybe a few breaks in the videos. Yeah. But yeah, we're gonna have a little fun in LA. I have the SoCo show. We're on a break as well because of the vacation, so check us out in 2 weeks. Other than that, just keep subscribing, liking the videos, putting out good work, and maybe you'll see me a few more times.
Absolutely. I was going to say he was on one of my podcasts recently, but I'll list the SoCo show and everything for that down below. Click that subscribe button, like button. Until next time, guys, we'll see you later.